Hello friends, and in this lecture we are going to discuss 8086 flag register. The flag register is 16 bit. So what is the flag register is? Consider if we are giving the any instruction to the ALU. So ALU is good the instructions and produces two things. One is called as results. Another is called as a status. So this result will be stored in the accumulator register, and the result, the status of the results will be stored in the flag register. So this, the result will be stored in the accumulator registers, and the status of that result will be stored in the flag register. So flag register is what? Flag register gives the status of the current results. Flag registers gives the status of the current results. So this is what total 16 bit. This is what 16 bit registers and 9 flags. This starting four is user defined, also called as undefined. OX stand for overflow flag. DX stand from directional flag. I stand from interrupt flag. S interrupt flag, and TX stand for trap flag. X stand for shine flag. Z stand for zero flag. AX stand from auxiliary flag. P is priority flag. And C is called as carry flag. So one by one we'll discuss what is the status of the current result. So first one we'll start from the carry flag. So overall total is what? 9 flags. In this, 6 is called as a status flag, and 3 is called as control flag. Which 3? Directional flag, interrupt flag, and trap flag. These 3 is called as control flag, because this is called as what? Also called as hardware control. This is used for the to control the hardware control. Another 6 is called as a status flag. So one by one we'll discuss. So here flag register we divide into two parts. One is called as a status flag, another is called as control flag. Control flag is directional flag, trap flag, and interrupt flag. This is also called as hardware flag. Another flag is over. So this flag is called as overflow flag, shine flag, zero flag, auxiliary flag, priority flag, and carry flag. So first we'll discuss one by one. First one is carry flag. So carry flag is CF is called to 1 when carry occurs in MSB, most significant bit. CF is called to 0 if no such carry. So I will give you the example. No such carry. Like consider if you are adding something here, 101011, something you are adding here, 8 bit number, you are adding this. So this is called as what? Your LSB. This is called as what? Your MSB. So if you carry occur in the most significant field, if you carry occur in the here, then it's said to be carry flag is 1, otherwise 0. Okay. So we'll take the example later, but we will discuss first. Okay. Second one is your priority flag. Priority flag. So priority flag is 1 if even priority. PF is equal to 0 if odd priority. Right. Consider you are getting the here after the sum something value you are getting here. So you count the number of ones. If we're getting the number of one is even, then parity flag is one. If we're getting the number of one is zero, then it's said to be parity flag is odd. Okay, so whenever the odd number of one is there, then it's said to be parity flag is zero. Whenever the even number of one is there, then parity flag is one. Now third one, auxiliary flag. Auxiliary flag, when auxiliary flag is 1, okay, auxiliary flag is 1, if carry occurs in LSB, AF is equal to 0, if no such carry. So this is called as what, LSB. If carry occurs is here, if carry occurs, then auxiliary flag is 1, otherwise 0. Otherwise, auxiliary flag is 0. Fourth one is 0 flag. If the result is 0, then the 0 flag is what? 1. 0 is, 0 flag is equal to 1 if result is 0. This result is completely 0, then 0 flag is 1. Otherwise, 0 flag will be 0. If result is not equal to 0. Next, fifth one is sign flag. Sign flag. So, sign flag is 1. SF is equal to 1 if MSB of the result is 1. MSB of result is 1. Sign flag is equal to 0 if MSB of result is 0. Okay, so students, so this is the 5 flag. Another is called as overflow flag. Overflow flag. This is 6th one. So overflow flag is equal to 1 when overflow occurs. Overflow occurs. An overflow is equal to 0 if no overflow occurs. No occurs. So what is the overflow here? We'll discuss this one in the detail. Another also we'll do in the example. First I will explain this overflow flag clearly. What is meaning by this overflow? And when the value is said to be overflow, yeah, in the range, we'll discuss once. This is the overflow flag. Overflow, if occurs, then is overflow flag is 1, otherwise 0. So in detail, we'll understand what is meaning by the overflow flag. This is the only the flag which is having, maybe having the doubts. So we'll do it first, clearly explanation about the overflow flag. So see, the number is two type. Signed number and unsigned number. Unsigned number is always positive. This is always positive. And signed number is maybe positive or negative. So both positive and negative. So we'll talk about this range. First is unsigned number. Unsigned number is always positive. So always positive means this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 bit is there. So this will be unsigned number. The total number of maximum range will be 2 to the power of 8. So 2 to the power 8 is equal to 256 bit. So this will be range lie of unsigned number is 0 to 256. This is what in the decimal. This one, if you convert in the hexadecimal, this range will be 0 to FFH. This will be the range of unsigned number. So what is this range of signed number? Signed number is both positive and negative. So signed number positive and negative will decide on 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this signed number, this is positive and negative, will decide on based on this MSB values. This is MSB values. If MSB is 1, if MSB is equal to 1, then is said to be negative number. Negative number. If MSB is 0, then is said to be positive numbers. So total these bits only will decide, only decides whether this number is positive or negative. Positive or negative. So this will not include in the number of countings. Yeah, number of how much range is there. So only we have only 7 positions. 7 positions. So that is what 2 to the power of 7 total number of permutation, the arrangement is there. So we can find it 128. So the range of Psi number is 0 to 127, because 128 is there, we started from 0, that's why 0 to 127. But this number is also for the negative number, so we can write it from the negative also, for minus 128 to 127, range for the unsigned number, range for the signed number. And we are finding this one, converting in the hexadecimal numbers, it will come -80H up to 0 to 7FH. So this is the range of signed number, yeah, unsigned number. This is basic, we already studied in the another subject, but keep in mind here, unsigned number range is 0 to FF. We have not discussed about this decimal number. In the microprocessor, we always discuss about this hexadecimal. So we'll keep in mind this tree, these numbers, 0 to FFH for the unsigned number. For signed number, the range is -80H to 0 up to the 7FH. 7FH in the range. So if anything value, if you come, if this is unsigned numbers and it's coming between the 0 to FFF, 0 to FF, then overflow flag is 0, because if coming in this range no overflow occurs, then overflow flag value is equal to 0. If this will come out of the range, then overflow value become 1. So this is the range we are talking about, the overflow. So keep in mind, always here note, for the signed number, overflow flag is for -80H up to 0 to 7FH. For the unsigned number, the range is 0 to FFH. Then we'll see the example for the whole problems. Example here, so 6 plus 2, this is all number is what, hexadecimal number. 6 plus 2 is 8, 9 plus A, foil edit here. So A plus 1 is B, C, D, E, F. Then again we'll start from 0, 1, 2, and 3. We are adding the 9 numbers. So A from 1, if you add it here, B, C, D, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So you will get it 3 and carry 1. Okay. So this one, I think you know this all addition in the hexadecimals. And if you don't know, then you can use in the calculator. But here we are trying to do the explanation about the flags. So 9 is, you can write it here, 1, 0, 0, 1. 6, you can write 1, 1. Sorry, 6 we can write it 0 1 1 0. A you can write it A is 10, 1 0 1 0, and 2 you can write 0 0 1 0. So when we add it here, 0 plus 0 is 0, 1 plus 0 is 0 carry 1, 1 plus 0 is 0 carry 1, and this is 1. So there is what, no any carry here, there is no any carry here. So now 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 0 is 1, 0 plus 0 is 0, 1 plus 1 is 0, and the carry is 1. So here is carry occurs. So here carry occurs, means carry occurs in the MSB. Carry occurs in the MSB, then is said to be carry flag is equal to 1. Carry if occurs in the LSB, then is said to be auxiliary flag is 1. But here carry does not occurs. So here become auxiliary flag is equal to 0. Now if you talk about the priority flag, what is the priority flag? If even priority, then is 1, otherwise 0. So this is what even a